फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर एस बी कॉलेज शिवाजी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज कन्नड़ डिस्ट्रिक्ट औरंगाबाद। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट न्यूटन्स लॉज ऑफ मोशन। सो फ्रेंड्स, व्हाई शुड वी स्टडी दिस लॉज? वी एक्सपीरियंस फिजिक्स एवरीवेयर इन आवर डेली लाइफ। विदाउट फिजिक्स वी कांट सर्वाइव। इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, व्हीकल, मोबाइल, एंटरटेनमेंट इक्विपमेंट्स, कंप्यूटर एंड सो आर द गिफ्ट्स गिवन बाय फिजिक्स। सो वी शुड हैव एन आइडिया ऑफ फिजिक्स कॉन्सेप्ट्स, इट्स डेरिवेटिव्स एंड लॉज इन्वॉल्व्ड इन इट। सो टुडे वी हैव डिसाइडेड टू डिस्कस इम्पोर्टेंट न्यूटन्स लॉज। सो फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन। व्हाट इज स्टेटमेंट ऑफ दिस लॉ? इट स्टेट्स दैट एन ऑब्जेक्ट विल रिमेन एट रेस्ट और इन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन इन स्ट्रेट लाइन अनलेस इट इज एक्टेड अपॉन बाय एक्सटर्नल अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स। सो हियर मोशन ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट इज रिलेटेड टू फोर्स। नाउ वी विल सी वन एग्जाम्पल। सी इन दिस इमेज, वन ग्लास इज केप्ट एंड इट इज कवर्ड बाय अ कार्डबोर्ड and a coin is placed on the cardboard. When we flip this cardboard, the coin will fall into the glass. See here, we are applying force to cardboard and not on the coin, but the coin maintains its state of rest, so it will fall into the glass. So the property of body to remain at rest or to remain in motion with constant velocity is called inertia. So Newton's first law is also called as Newton's law of inertia, means laws of inertia. The first law states that if the net force is zero, the velocity of object is constant. Its velocity remains constant. So see, this is mathematical expression of that law. So friends, we will discuss now second law of motion. So first see statement, it states that the rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to applied force, and the change in momentum takes place in the direction of applied force. So this can be shown by this mathematical expression, F is equal to dp by dt, so equal to d dt of mv. So p is momentum, it is given by mass into velocity mv, so is equal to m into dv by dt. So dv by dt is nothing but it is acceleration, so it equal to ma, so F is equal to ma. Now see this one image is shown here. In first case, the mass of the block is 10 kg. In second case, the mass of the block is also 10 kg, means the mass is same in both the cases. Now force applied on first block is greater, force applied on second block is less. So see here, in first case force is greater, acceleration will be greater. In second case force is less, acceleration will be less. In second image, the mass of first block is 5 kg, mass of second block is 10 kg, but force applied on each block is same. So we can say the force is greater, mass is less, then acceleration will be greater. In second case, mass is greater and force is also there. So in this case, mass greater, so acceleration will be less. So in first case, acceleration is proportional to applied force. In second image, acceleration is proportional to 1 upon m, means it is inversely proportional to mass. So friends, Newton's third law of motion, we can state it, for every action there is equal and opposite reaction. This can be shown by this rocket. You see, the fuel is burnt in the rocket. It is ejaculated in backward direction, and rocket gains momentum in forward direction. Means action and reaction are equal here. So friends, we have discussed here Newton's laws of motion. Thank you.